Hello friends, I am Maunika. Hope you all are good and safe. Welcome back to Learn HTML. Happy to see you all again in this HTML course. A warm welcome to you all. In today's video, we are going to discuss the concept of list. In previous video, we discussed the concept of links, right? In previous video, we discussed how to link a web page to another web page. Or we can say how to link our web page to some other website. We discussed what is web page, what is website, what is web, right? And in our web page, we linked another website, right? With the help of anchor tag, we achieved this functionality. We have seen what are the various attributes of anchor tag, and we have seen what are the purposes of anchor tag, what is the use of anchor tag. We have seen these steps. And finally, we learned one more concept, named anchors. Named anchors in the sense, linking something within our web page. Or we can say linking something inside our web page. This is what the concept of named anchors, right? So these steps we learned in previous video. And finally, with the help of those steps, we coded one exercise. So these things we discussed in previous video. So if you don't know these steps, or if you didn't watch my previous videos, I will provide links of my previous videos in my description box. Kindly check over there. I request you to watch my previous videos. Because if you watch my previous videos, you can get a better continuity over here. Okay. Let us proceed into today's content. Before entering into today's content, if you didn't subscribe my channel, kindly subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my videos. Okay. Without further delay, let us enter into today's content. So this is what the agenda for today. So today we are going to discuss the concept of a list. So list in the sense, bunch of information. Okay, in our day-to-day life, we will be facing many lists, right? So each and every person in the world will have their own wish list, right? For example, I'm saying wish list. Okay, each and every person will have their own wish list, right? So for example, I want to study well, I want to score well in exams, I want to get placement, I want to get nice job, I want to get high salary, I want to build a house, I want to buy a car, I want to live a luxurious life. So this is what wish list. This may be a wish list for some person. Okay, so this is what list. Okay, we will be seeing lots of lists in our day-to-day life, right? So there is no interior meaning in that. So list means, list is a general word, okay? Bunch of information, we will be calling it as list. So in today's class, we are going to focus on this type of list. So we are having three type of list: ordered list, unordered list, and definition list. We can categorize list into three types: ordered, unordered, and definition. So we are going to discuss detailly about these three lists. Okay, we are going to discuss detailly about these three lists. Okay, so let me explain. Okay, so instead of explaining here, let me explain this in my web browser and text editor practically, so you can understand better. Let me explain practically. So let me open my text editor and my web browser. This is my Sublime text editor. And let me open my web browser also. This is my web browser, right? This is my web browser. This is our HTML web page we have created in last few videos, right? Okay, now we can continue here. So first, let me explain ordered list and unordered list. We have three types of list, right? Ordered list, unordered list, and definition list. So first, let me explain ordered list and unordered list, and then we may move into definition list. Okay, so exercise for these steps we will be discussing in next video, because nested list is pending. Nested list in the sense, list inside list, or we can say list within list. Okay, so this is what the concept of nested list. So we will be discussing nested list in next video. So in next video, we can solve one exercise for list. Okay, so in that exercise, we can solve for ordered list, unordered list, definition list, and nested list. Okay, so for this steps, we will be discussing exercise in next video. So in today's video, we are going to discuss the content alone. Okay, concept alone. So let me explain ordered list and unordered list first. Here you can see ingredients to prepare biryani. Okay, so this is what the list of ingredients to prepare biryani, right? So what are the list of ingredients to prepare biryani? Rice, onion, ghee, water, tomato, ginger garlic paste, beans, carrot, green peas, turmeric powder, chili powder, biryani masala powder, coriander leaves, mint leaves, masala items, etc. So these are some list of ingredients to prepare biryani, right? So I can say this is an unordered list. Why? Because here order is not mandated. We can change order however we want. Okay, order is not mandated. Okay, you can write rice first, or you can write some other things first. You can write water first, you can write beans first. Okay, if you change the order of this list, you can change order of list of ingredients. Meaning will not change, content will not affect. Okay, so this is what unordered list. You can change the order however you want. Meaning will not get affected. Okay, so if you say ingredients to someone, how to prepare biryani, if you say ingredients for preparing biryani to someone, you can say it in any order. There is no restriction to specify order here, right? So there is no restriction to specify rice first and onion second and masala items last. There is no restriction like this, right? So we can specify ingredients in any order. We can say ingredients, or we can code ingredients in any order. We can code this list in any order, right? There is no such some specific order. The order is not mandatory over here, right? So this is what the unordered list. Okay, so now here this is ordered list, cooking steps to prepare biryani. This is ordered list. Why? Because see, cooking steps is ordered, right? So if you complete first step, then only you can enter into second step. Okay, first step is pour ghee in pressure cooker and put the masala items in it. Fry that by adding onion, tomato, mint and ginger garlic paste. If you want to fry it by adding onion, tomato, mint and ginger garlic paste, prior to that you need to pour ghee in pressure cooker and put the masala items in it. After completing second step, you can't do first step. If you do like this, means meaning will change. Dish will get completely collapsed, right? Here we cannot change the order. Order is mandatory. Here there are restrictions in order. Okay, if you complete first step, then only you can enter into second step. If you complete second step, then only you can enter into third step. So if you want to enter into final step, you need to complete these six steps. If you didn't complete these six steps, you cannot enter into final step. Okay, so here order is mandatory. So in unordered list, order is not mandatory. We can code or we can write it in any order. Okay, in ordered list, order is mandatory. We should code in some specific order. If someone asks you what are the cooking steps to prepare biryani, you should say in this order only. You cannot change the order. If you change the order, dish will get collapsed, right? So this is what the order steps to prepare biryani. So this is ordered list. Ingredients, the list of ingredients is unordered list. Here the list of steps or list of procedures is ordered list, right? We cannot say this is a paragraph. This is list of ingredients, right? We cannot say this is a paragraph. This is not paragraph, this is list. Okay, similarly, this is not paragraph. Okay, this is not paragraph. So this is also what? A list, right? This is not paragraph. This is also list. Okay, we cannot say this is a paragraph. Okay, so in list we are having many types. So we need to specify the type: unordered list or ordered list or definition list. I will be explaining definition list after completing these two lists. Okay, hope you can get a better idea about ordered list and unordered list. In unordered list, we can change the order however we want. No problem in that. If you change the order, meaning will not affect. Meaning will not get changed. But in ordered list, if you change order, meaning will affect. Meaning will change. Okay, so this is what the concepts of unordered list and ordered list. Now let us discuss how to code unordered list and ordered list in our HTML web page. Now let us discuss this. Okay, first let me show you how to code unordered list in our HTML web page. Okay, now this is my text editor, right? As you know, I'm using Sublime text editor. So let me copy this first. Okay, this is what unordered list, right? Let me copy it, Control C. Let me paste it over here. Okay, see, ingredients to prepare biryani is of type heading. So I'm using heading tag. According to size, you can use any heading tag. Okay, I'm using H3 heading tag. According to size, you can use any heading tag, no problem. Okay. Okay. Now, as I said earlier, this is of type list. This is not paragraph, right? So to know, to make our system to treat this as list type of information, I'm going to use li tag. Li stands for list. Here price is a list, right? So each and every content is list. Okay, so I'm opening li tag. If a tag is opened, that particular tag should get closed, right? So I'm closing li tag here. Okay, now let me copy this opening tag, Control C. I'm coding for every ingredients. Let me code it for all ingredients. Let me code it for all ingredients. Sorry. Okay. Now. Let me code it, please wait patiently. Okay, similarly, let me copy closing tag also here. Okay, so here also I'm going to copy this opening tag. After copying, let me explain the procedure, don't worry. Okay, now hope you can understand this. See, now our system will treat rice as a list, onion as a list, ghee as a list, water as a list. Okay, our system will treat each and every content is of list type. Okay, so it's not paragraph. If you use paragraph tag, then physical appearance may be same, but logically it's incorrect because these are list of ingredients. So list tag is appropriate tag to code this. Okay, so after coding this, we need to specify the type of list. So this is of type unordered list, right? This is of type unordered list. As I said earlier, if you change order, nothing wrong. Okay, if you change order, meaning will not change. Meaning will not get affected. Content will not get affected, right? So this is of unordered list, right? So let me open UL tag here. Okay, UL stands for unordered list. Let me close that particular tag over here. Okay, so this is what unordered list. Okay, so that's why I'm opening unordered tag here, and here also I'm closing unordered list tag there. Okay, so UL stands for unordered list. Okay, so this is of type heading. Okay, as a whole, this is of type unordered list. Okay, so as an individual, rice is of type list, onion is of type list, ghee is of type list, water is of type list, tomato is of type list. Okay, as a whole, this is of type unordered list. Now let me show you in the web browser. Control S. This is what our web browser, right? Let me reload it. You can see the list, right? This is what the list of ingredients. So this is unordered list. Similarly, we can code for ordered list also. So this is ordered list, right? So let me copy this. Okay, cooking steps to prepare biryani. This is heading. So let me use heading tag. Okay, let me close heading tag here. Okay, now I need to make my system to treat this content as list. Okay, to treat each and every content as list. So let me use li tag here. Li stands for list. Okay, if I open such tag, I need to close it, right? That's why I'm closing here. Okay, similarly, I'm going to copy for each and every statement. Sorry, let me copy it. Let me copy it for every statements. Okay, here also I'm going to copy closing tab. Okay, that's it. Okay, now this is of type ordered. This list is of type ordered, right? So this is ordered list. So I'm going to use OL tag. OL stands for ordered list. UL stands for unordered list. OL stands for ordered list. Let me close it and let me show you in my web browser. See this. Now in browser you can notice the difference, right? So in ordered list there is number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. In unordered list there is bullet points, right? So the interior meaning of this is that in unordered list this bullet point indicates you can change order. Okay, you can write this or you can code this in any order. Order is not mandatory over here, but here order is mandatory. Here there are number, right? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. If you complete first step, then only you can enter into second step. Okay, if you complete second step, then only you can enter into third step. Okay, if you want to enter into seventh step or last step, you need to complete this six steps first. Okay, if you didn't complete these six steps, you cannot enter into seventh step. So this is what ordered list. Okay, so if you want to remove this bullets, that is of presentation, we will be learning this while learning about CSS. Okay, so now you need to know what are the main concepts of unordered list and ordered list. Okay, so this is what the unordered list and ordered list. In unordered list, order is not mandatory. If you change the order, meaning will not change, meaning will not get affected. Okay, so you can change the order however you want, but in ordered list you cannot change the order. Okay, order is mandatory. If you change the order, meaning will change. Okay, this is what the main concept behind ordered list and unordered list. Okay, so far we completed two lists, ordered list and unordered list, right? Now definition list is pending, right? Now we can see definition list. Definition list is so easy. So this is what the example for definition list. So the main example, or we can say the exact example for definition list, is dictionary. So in dictionary there will be a particular word, and after that they will be giving the meaning for the particular word, right? Or we can say they will be giving description of the particular word, right? So these types of list are called as definition list. As you can see here, there are many languages: HTML, CSS, JavaScript, C++. There are many languages, right? So this is what the description of that particular language, HTML. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. It is the standard markup language for describing the structure of web pages. With HTML you can create your own website. So this is what the description of this particular language, right? So similarly, this is what the description of the CSS. So this is what description of JavaScript. So this is description of C and this is the description of C++. Okay, so in ordered and unordered list, we are using li tag, right? Li stands for list. So here, instead of li tag, we will be using two tags. Okay, what are the two tags? Means dt and dd. DD stands for definition description and DT stands for definition term. Okay, so here this is what the definition term, this is what the content for definition term. Okay, which term is going to define? I'm going to define about HTML, right? So here HTML is the definition term. Similarly, here I'm going to define CSS, right? So CSS is the definition term. Similarly, here I'm going to define JavaScript, right? So here JavaScript is the definition term. Similarly, here I'm going to refer about C. So C is the definition term. Similarly, I'm defining C++. So definition term is C++. Okay, so this is what the definition term. Definition description in the sense, the description for the definition term. So this is definition term. This is the definition or description for this definition term, right? So this is definition description. Okay, so we'll be coding this using DT tag. That means definition term tag. We'll be coding this particular content using DD tag. That means definition description tag. Okay, so if you want to code definition list in your HTML web page, we will be using two tags, okay, DT and DD. So let me show you practically, you can understand. Okay, this is what definition list, right? So I'm opening DL tag. DL stands for definition list. I'm closing DL tag. Okay, I'm closing DL tag. So inside that, I'm going to give content. Okay, I'm going to enclose, I'm going to wrap this content inside the DL tag. Okay, so this content is enclosed by DL tag. That means definition list. So this is what definition list, right? Now this is definition term. Which term you are going to define? This is what definition term. So let me copy this information first. And let me show you. Okay, now this is definition term, right? DT stands for definition term. Okay, let me close it over here. Similarly, I'm going to code it for all languages. DT. I'm going to close it over here. Similarly. Okay, similarly, let me copy this DT, opening tag of DT, and let me paste it for all definition terms. So in a definition list, there will be list of definition terms and list of definition description. Okay, see, in ordered list and unordered list, there are some lists, right? This list is called as unordered list and this list is called as ordered list. Similarly, in definition list, we will be having list of definition terms and list of definition description. We are using many li tags, or we can say list of li tags in ordered and unordered list, right? So instead of li tag, we will be using list of dt tag and list of dd tag in definition list. Okay, so let me close the tag over here. So this is what definition term. Definition term in the sense, which term you are going to define. This is what definition term. Here I'm going to define about HTML. So HTML is the definition term. Here I'm going to define about CSS. So CSS is the definition term. Here I'm going to define about JavaScript. So JavaScript is the definition term. Here I'm going to define about C. So C is the definition term. Here I'm going to define about C++. So C++ is the definition term. So description is definition description. Okay, this is what the description for the particular definition term, right? So let me code it using DD tag. So DD stands for definition description. Okay, similarly, let me do it for other descriptions also. let me code it for other description. Hope you can understand what is the meaning behind DT and DD. So DT stands for definition term, DD stands for definition description. Okay, which term you are going to define, that content you need to wrap in DT, and which what is the description, that content you need to define in DD. Okay, now let me save and show you in my web browser. You can see it, right? So this is the definition term, this is the description for this particular definition term. This term I'm defining CSS here, so this is definition term, this is the description for this definition term. Similarly JavaScript, C and C++. Okay, hope you can understand the types of list, ordered, unordered and definition list. So this we have completed all the concepts, we have completed the agenda for today. So ordered list, in the sense order is mandatory. If you change the order, okay, if you change the order, meaning will change, okay, or we can say meaning will affect, it will affect the meaning. If you change the order, it will affect the meaning. As you can see here, here there are numbers 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so this number indicates order is mandatory. Okay, so you need to complete one first, then only you can enter into two. Okay, if you want to enter into five, you need to complete these four steps first. Okay, if you didn't complete these four steps, you cannot enter into five. If you enter into five without completing these steps, meaning will change. So this is what the ordered list. Unordered list, in unordered list, order is not mandatory. Okay, we can change the order however we want. If you change the order however we want, or however if you change the order however you want, meaning will not get affected, content will remain same. Definition list, so if you want to define a particular word, okay, if you want to define a particular word, if you have list of words to define, okay, I'm having list of languages to define, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, C, C++. Okay, if you have list of languages to define, we will be having definition term and definition description. Okay, so this list is called as definition list. Exact example or well-known example is dictionary. Okay, so these are the types of list, ordered, unordered and definition. So we'll be using list of li tags for specifying ordered and unordered list. We'll be using list of dt and dd tags for specifying definition list. So this is what the main concept of list. Almost the concept of list is over, still nested list is pending. So we will be seeing nested list in next video. So after completing nested list, we will be seeing exercise for this, don't worry. We will be seeing exercises for unordered, ordered, definition list, as well as nested list. So we can see as a whole. Okay, so we'll be seeing exercise, don't worry. Okay, so I hope I completed my agenda for today. I hope this session is interesting. I hope you can understand all concepts that was delivered by me today. Okay, thank you so much for your patience listening. Now I would like to wind up my session. So before ending my session, so if this video is useful to you, kindly hit the like button. Share this video to your friends and relatives, those who are interested to learn HTML or those who are interested to become a web developer. If this video is useful to you, subscribe our channel and click the like and click the bell icon. Please hit the like button. So if you have any doubts or if you have any expectations or suggestions, you can comment me in the comment section or you can mail me. My mail ID is in the description box. So you can mail me. I'll be reading all comments and mails. No problem. Okay, hope this session is interesting. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. I would like to wind up my session. Thank you for your patience listening. See you all in my next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.